morning, everyone. I'm Dr. Nissim Khan, founder and CEO of AquiNovo, accelerating growth of farmed fish. I would like to start with a Flemish painter, Jean Boudet, who illustrated the Brussels fish market back in the 16th century, when fishing vessels brought the yield of the day to the local market and people gathered to meet and buy. Take a good look at this picture. Needless to say that the world has changed dramatically since then, with the fish supply from the sea depleted on the one hand and growing population on the other, the world increasingly relies on aquaculture as the main source for fish. Yet to meet this demand, aquaculture needs sustainable solutions to increase yield. And yield, ladies and gentlemen, is the name of the game. We at AquiNovo developed technology to make fish grow faster. An increase in size in fish is about 25%, as you can see clearly in this initial lab experiment. Accelerating growth means reaching optimal market weight sooner and increasing fish farm revenues. Current methods to accelerate growth are mostly based on procedures of growth and addition of materials such as nutrients, vitamins, proteins, and so on. We at AquiNovo are taking a different approach. We inhibit puberty. Why should we do that? Because puberty and growth are linked processes, and inhibiting puberty may enhance growth. For instance, tilapia is being grown for about a year until it reaches the market, but it matures early at the age of 3 months, where females stop growing and start mating and hatching for the next 3 to 4 months. So beyond the loss of biomass, obviously there are a lot of new kids in town that will not reach market size at the day of harvest. So our technology is based on proprietary materials, blocks key receptors in the fish production systems. Those materials will be incorporated into the fish feed and will be given to the fish in a limited time period before or during puberty onset. We are not using hormones, nor do we introduce any new genes into the fish, and we do not expect any residues of the materials in the fish or the water. Initial proof of concept studies demonstrated that gonad development was arrested and 10% more weight was observed in mature male tilapia that were injected with our materials. Even stronger effect of about 25% was observed with young tilapia that were fed with our materials. We have initial indications that the technology is applicable for salmon as well, and this is the basis for further experiment with both salmon and trout, which are closely related. By using AquiNovo materials, fish farm will increase revenues through shortened time to market, lower production, and potentially add growth cycles with existing infrastructure. Our non-GM, non-hormonal technology should also prevent escapees reproduction in the wild and may replace the use of hormones in current tilapia farming. Our data and experiments are for tilapia, but since the relevant biological system exists in all fin fish, we believe that the system is applicable, technology is applicable for all fish farmed for human consumption. Our first two products are targeting tilapia and salmon with projected annual with projected market potential of over $1 billion annually. We plan to obtain regulatory approval for our product as feed additives and sell them to feed manufacturers. This will support market-focused development and advances access to markets. We are currently in discussions in this context. We are currently in discussions with the potential partners, including a large feed company. So we started our path to market in 2015 with filing our patent application, and we are planning for the next 2 years to progress with the development of our first two products for tilapia and salmon. We are focused now on solving a clear, challenging market need while looking ahead to support sustainability and address additional challenges emerging from the new and growing aquaculture market. We are next going to start a new funding round, and we'll be happy to speak with all of you later on in this event. Thank you very much.
The question I'm going to ask you is, I'm sure because you're using a compound, and that compound goes into the food chain in the fish, and eventually you'll go into human consumption. How do you address the issue of safety and sustainability for human consumption in the longer term?
Yeah, thank you. Very good question. Well, actually, safety studies, of course, are part of our development process, and we are planning to start it as early as possible. Since we are talking about a compound that we know about its chemical nature, we believe it will not last long in the fish itself nor in the water. And of course, this will have to be shown as part of the regulatory study that we will be holding.